Nowadays, the mankind is watching, astonished, the extraordinary and unusual worldwide fact that moves daily as in a giant billiard table. Enormous ciphers flying around as bits and bytes at the speed of the light, transferring from one point to another of the planet fabulous fortunes in a true speculative orgy, completely dissociated from reality, without any correspondence with the real reach of our physical world, the so-called conversation. It seems to those not fully aware, and we shall include here sadly the great majority of citizens, that this process is creating a world in which everyone will have access to a higher standard of life with greater social justice. That fact comes to us by the media as a cure-all for the biggest world problems. As a matter of fact, it is necessary to be pointed out that only 2 to 3% of all those transactions raise into $3 trillion a day. Only 2 to 3% refer to commercial and industrial activities. On the other hand, the great majority of the financial transactions is purely speculative, as if money by itself would be able to generate more money as a fantasy that is carrying the world economy to a bad end. Until the 70s, the Bretton Woods rules were followed. Money to flow between nations needed the previous government authorization. There was a fixed exchange rate between the currencies of the greatest industrialized nations. The Fed assured with the gold equivalent in the transaction. In other words, there were restrictions to the flow of speculative money. In 1973, the US government imposed an unilateral rupture and the barriers disappeared. Gold reserves are no longer necessary. Money is no more the wealth symbol. It is the wealth proper, a fiction in such a way that goes to the edge of insanity. Supported by a group of worldwide institutions, the so-called international financial system. And here are included the IMF, the World Bank, the World Trade Organization, and so on. That is the money empire, the false money, the real speculation, conducting the mankind to its ruin and destruction. Well, gentlemen, it is with that false money that mega speculators through the world are willing to buy the real interest of all developing countries. In Brazil, they are selling all by the dozen all of our strategic state companies. The right words are these. They are giving away all of our strategic resources, including Vale do Rodolfo Company, the greatest iron mining company in the world, by only $3 billion, equivalent to less than half of 1% of its estimated value. We have the greatest reserves in the world of niobium, titanium, first quality quartz. We are the greatest gold producers in Latin America. We have the richest subsoil in this planet, and we are seeing our riches going there cheap to the industrializing countries. President Clinton, during the Summit of the Americas in Santiago recently said, "Your prosperity lifts ours, our prosperity." Really true? From the Brazilian states of Amapá, the Minas Gerais, we carried millions of tons of manganese sold by insignificant prices. Now, in those Brazilian states, we have our big land craters, homes, and our manganese rests in Pennsylvania. It's now part of the U.S. strategic inventory. In the future, we'll have to pay whatever price they want for that same mineral. Let me call your attention to another fact. We are not only the richest country in the world, for while in at least one state of the US it is necessary the desalinization of water for having fresh water, we have importation of industrialized products and even food. Our party, Plena, rises against that process. It's imperative a new Bretons, but as we don't have the condition to impose such an agreement on the international scenario, and as we do have in our country all that we need for our survival, there is only one option not to drown. We'll break with the international financial system. We'll no longer accept this speculator's extortion. We'll sit down for negotiations, impose our sovereignty. We'll price our goods with justice. The interest rates that we pay shall be the lowest possible. That is the only way to proclaim our economic independence. Thank you very much.